give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. We welcome you to the Spice of Life Variety Show. As you can see, we are beautiful women surrounded by the beauty of paintings. Yes. We invite you to grab a pen, paper, and copy down our email information, our phone number, our P.O. box. Contact us. You may want to very well do that once you really see the artist and her artwork. We praise God for you. We bring you greetings from the West Angeles Church of God in Christ. We love you. And again, thank you for tuning in. God bless you. Pamela, Pink, Diane Webb, how you doing?
You know we love the colors, don't we?
We
how
love
you
colors.
Doing today?
Doing wonderful, girl.
All right. We talked about the artwork, right?
Yes, yes.
Well, we're going to meet the artist.
Okay.
Buena.
Okay.
A.K.A. Uh-huh. B.J. Johnson.
Oh, my goodness. And what a phenomenal piece of work and
yes.
pieces of work that you have done.
Thank
Welcome
you.
To this show.
Thank you so much. How are the both of you?
Both fine, fine. Once again, you pronounce her name because I'm going to refer to her as A.K.A. Exactly. So again, her name is?
Buena Johnson.
Right. And so you will hear me reference B.J. That's how I don't want to be
And that is fine.
And
that is, yes, yes.
Okay, yes. Now, who first noticed that you had this kind of talent?
Well, you know, I had to think about that. I would say it was my elementary school teacher.
Really?
Her oh. name is Miss Polk. And she was so instrumental. She was like the wind beneath my wings,
okay.
so to speak. No matter, you know, the caliber of my work, she always made sure that my work was front and center. It was
oh,
showcased.
Really?
And the thing I think back, what made me feel so good about it, is that she made me feel like my work was on the level of being presented before kings and presidents
oh,
and
wow.
whatnot. You know, mm. even though something may have been a little askew or whatnot mm-hmm. like that, you would never know it if, you know, if she had to say anything about it or if she had to show it.
Really?
So that was such an inspiration to me.
That's
wow.
amazing that even back then, because, so then in that case, then you were indicating that you've been an artist really for a number of years.
I'm young. But, in a wise for my years.
But that's amazing though. Now, how far before that, prior to that, do you remember sketching, drawing?
Actually, Dr. Lewis and Sister Webb, mm-hmm. is I started in art as, actually my interest in art began in childhood, even before school age, that I believe that God implanted the gift and passion for art. And I was one that I would wake up in the morning, I would go to sleep at night, I would dream of it, you know, that, that I, it was just phenomenal to
mm-hmm.
me
mm-hmm.
of how a human being could create such, you know. And so to get the understanding of it, I said, you know, I've got to do this.
Mm-hmm.
I've got to break into this and find out how a human person can do this,
mm-hmm.
you know. And so I challenged myself,
right.
you know, to try to create this, even before school age,
oh.
you know, more than I wanted to eat, play. I mean, I would go into my sisters and brothers' notebooks and borrow.
You clean it up, okay.
Borrow,
okay.
Some of their images.
Okay.
And I would just be mesmerized. I would sit in there for hours just looking at the artwork and just trying to figure out, oh my God, how incredible this is.
Mm.
You know, so yeah, it was implanted. And to go back to the question you asked earlier, even my high school teachers, said that they thought that they saw something there, so they would sign me up for scholarships and whatnot like that. And one of the greatest things that happened is even in studying, because I've studied, you know, vastly, is that one of the teachers, even though I was an undergrad,
uh-huh.
wanted me to teach one of the classes to show my technique.
Oh.
And then also asked me to mentor a grad student.
Oh, mentor a grad student.
Oh, yes. I said, mm-hmm. you know, this is obviously
That's
God,
mm-hmm.
you know, and I'm humbled by
mm-hmm.
it. I am.
You made a statement, and it just sort of ties in with what you just said, that you want your artwork, I have it. I am grateful that my work inspires and pleases others, and I am humbled to have the gift of art.
Absolutely.
So you recognize that it is a gift.
Oh my
from
goodness.
God Almighty.
Well, Dr. Lewis and Sister Webb, I have to tell you, when I sit down to do work, it is not me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if it comes out wrong, yeah, it was me.
You take the blame. I'll take the
but
blame.
Yes, I have to accept that. But I must allow the inspiration of the Holy Spirit to guide me, mm-hmm. to direct the art. You know, when it is when I'm at a difficult point that I know it's too much of me in it, I have to back off and I say, Father, you direct me how you want this to go. Right. So if it comes out right and you love it, you know that's buena backed off, mm-hmm. and that's why I must give the credit and praise to the Almighty, you know, because I passionately love the gift and blessings that he'd given to me, mm-hmm. you know, in art.
And you have to, because of your paintings, as the audience can observe, even as they are looking mm-hmm. on at the paintings, they're very detailed. It's not just where you've drawn a large piece and called it art, but you are very detailed mm-hmm. in what you do. I mean, it's such a phenomenal drawings and details and colors. We love colors.
Thank you.
And of course, that's one of your trademarks, mm-hmm. colorful artwork.
Huh? Absolutely.
And black and white.
Actually, I have to go back a little bit in history and say this, that, you know, I studied in universities, and I have a Bachelor's of Science in Education to teach K-12. And I did that because my parents said, well, you love art, you're good in art, but how are you going to make a living? You know, that's quote unquote.
That's the question.
And I was doing some undergrad study at the Cleveland Institute of Art. And on that campus, you have Case Western, you have Cleveland Clinic. So you had all these lawyers and doctors walking by looking at us like, poor thing.
They're going to star themselves.
They're going to have to marry. They're going to have to marry big. You know. And also studied at the Pratt Institute of Art in Brooklyn, New York, where I received a bachelor's in fine art and communication design. And I brought that up to say that during my studies, because these were pretty much predominantly private institutions, I had very little exposure to blacks in art. Mm-hmm. And the little exposure that I did get, it was negative, it was not positive.
Okay.
And so that was the impetus for me, that when, you know, as my abilities increased and God blessed me, to make sure that I showed African Americans, our Nubian queens and kings, in a positive light. Mm-hmm. And so therefore, that's why you see a lot of that in my work. But I'm not just, you know, a black artist doing black work. I want my work to be universal.
Right.
And I have no problem with, you know, doing all ethnic races, because we are all one mm-hmm. here. And to state that is because how my work transpires or transverses, you know, where it is, that one of my biggest collectors is Mr. Dick Van Dyke. Oh. You know, he and his wife, you know. Uh-huh. And they purchased a picture of Sammy Davis. And also I did a portrait of Frank Sinatra. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And they purchased that to make it a gift mm-hmm. to Barbara Sinatra. Mm-hmm.
Oh.
So mm-hmm. I'm saying that to show that it crosses all lines. And that's what I want it to do.
Of course.
You know,
right.
So
since we're in this element, this area here, what other celebrities have you encountered in your artwork?
Wow, I've just been so privileged, I have to say, you know, because it's not buena, you know, mm-hmm. Being able to be in these environments to meet these people. I was commissioned by the Genesee Center, which is Halle Berry's favorite charity, mm-hmm. to do a portrait of Halle Berry. Mm-hmm. So she's number one. And I just thought that I was going to do the portrait, you know, get paid.
Yes.
And then they would present it to her.
Okay.
But they were so wonderful. Actually, they set it up where I was in a private room. It was a black tie event. And they ushered Halle. She did not know because it was a surprise.
Okay.
And they ushered Halle Berry in. And she didn't know why she was there. And then the unveiling took place, you know, all the cameras mm-hmm. and whatnot. And the one thing that our artists want to know, because, you know, I had not up to that point met her personally, does it look like her?
Right.
And does she think it looks like her?
So, two important questions.
Absolutely. Okay. And she's going to like it. Okay. So therefore, when the unveiling took place, after greeting her, she got this close. I mean, just right up on the painting, eye to eye. She looked at it for like about a solid minute. Uh-huh. And you know, when you're wondering, you know, minutes feel like an hour ticking by, right?
Exactly.
And she turned around with this huge grin across her face, just big grin, and she says, wow. And I'm like,
wow.
And that was just wonderful. She loved it. Mm-hmm. And as a matter of fact, later, as a thank you, which I didn't expect, she had a special driver to deliver to my home a huge vase of the most exotic flowers and a personal note thanking me for the portrait.
Oh, mm. Wow. And that was right up your alley, because you're into flora. Don't you have something going on? in that area?
Well, let me just, I'm into all kinds of things.
Exactly.
Yes,
okay.
Yes.
Okay.
But the thing is about that too, what was great about the event, because, you know, an artist get their fame from exposure and notoriety. And there also was Jim Hill. And I must add, you know, this is for personal, he's more fine in person than I thought. Wink, wink. And also Cedric the Entertainer, you know, and they all posed with the pictures and whatnot, and it was on television. So that was a great, great event.
Wow.
And let's see, who else should I say? Well, of course, as I mentioned, Dick Van Dyke.
Mm-hmm.
He's
mm-hmm.
an awesome collector.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, he visited me in Malibu at a show more than once. I wasn't aware of it, and someone said, well, Dick Van Dyke was just in your booth, and I'm like, yeah, right. And so my daughter came to get me and said, yes, someone wants to see you. She didn't know, you know, the younger generation, she
right,
knew who he was.
Uh-huh.
I step in, there he is. And so therefore, yeah, he and his wife began to name the pieces they wanted and to purchase.
Oh.
So that was an awesome occasion as well.
Wonderful. Sydney Poitier.
Yes, I did an event. I was invited by Mr. Tavis Smiley.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he does a lot for youth.
Mm-hmm.
And Arianna Huffington was one of the hosts. She had it in her home. And as a surprise, also, they had commissioned me to do a portrait of her to thank her for being so generous and hosting such a huge event
mm-hmm.
in her home.
Mm-hmm.
And again, you know, me with my question,
wow.
Is she going to like it?
Wow.
And I wish I could show you the pictures. It was just phenomenal. She loved it. And in present there was also, as you mentioned, Sydney Poitier, Bernie Casey, Vivica Fox, all of those.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, for me, I'm like, okay, mm-hmm. go get them.
You
know, make them your client.
You know, one of the things that really inspired me as I read your bio and your history was the fact that you would use, and maybe you still do, but especially when you were younger, you use your artwork, your drawings
mm-hmm.
to escape into a place of happiness, and,
oh, yes.
and in other words, you will create the surroundings
mm.
around you.
Absolutely.
And so you were giving you were giving something positive to not have to turn to something negative. Huh?
Absolutely,
mm.
absolutely. Thank you. And yes, art was like my friend, my salvation, my savior. Because
uh-huh.
you know, many, and I'll just say it, many of you think artists are a different strange being anyway.
You and have to be licensed, but no, you're not.
And therefore, I felt that I was not understood, and I didn't feel like the world understood me because I guess because of my inner inspirations and so forth. So yeah, that was my comfort, and actually, it was my challenge. It was my way of breaking out of myself, should I say? Because I would go in my room and. For me, the world would open up. My room would be full, you know, bursting to the seams because I was creating, you know.
Mm.
And then I would get to the point I would challenge myself. You know, if I saw something that would just, you know, take my breath away, I said, okay, I'm going to do it better.
Okay.
Not match it, but let me see if I can do it better, you know. So that's like in reference to my work. I'm a fanatic as far as in detail. And I attribute that to the High Renaissance period, German High Renaissance period, where I reflected on Albrecht Dürer. He has a love for line and detail. And again, I reflect to Albert mm-hmm. Dürer, German High Renaissance, because again, didn't have black studies, African Americans, you know, which you have like Charles White now, magnificent artists, mm-hmm. black artists and whatnot to relate to. So yes, I would go into that and again, that relates to my work because I love the detail. To me, the detail is what makes a person, you know,
I agree.
Makes the expression.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I love portraiture, because for me, not only trying to get a likeness,
mm-hmm.
but also to go into the spirit, into the soul, to get
soul.
A glimpse
mm-hmm.
of the soul mm-hmm. of that person
mm-hmm.
and bring it out on canvas. Things that they didn't know were there would show up, you know.
You had made reference, that you went to your siblings' notebooks and get their images.
Borrow.
So does that mean that they also have this gift?
Thank you for asking. Actually, let me say first and foremost, I have an 18-year-old daughter, which I can't believe she's 18.
Who can believe that, really?
And she's a film and television major at Cal State Northridge.
Mm-hmm.
And she has actually won acclaim locally and nationally in fine art and photography, and she's a writer. So she's quite gifted. But, you know, her love, her passion is film and television. So yeah, she's gifted, you know, and of course mom is partial.
Yes, of course mom would be.
Mom is partial. But I have judges to you know, I didn't judge the event she was in. So
so it's a true,
true line.
If you got it, you just got it, you know.
And I have nephews and nieces who were gifted in the talent of art as well. And I remember my mother, you know, because I was the youngest child, just to entertain me, because it was just she and I home, she would draw pictures for me, little images, which she thought were nothing, but she didn't know. I was like eating it up.
Wow.
I mean, I was cherishing every image. And she would say, oh, this is nothing, you know, and I'm like, oh, mom, please just keep drawing. Do some more, do some more. So that was a delight
for me. So she was an artist in her own right in that regard?
Yes, she was, even though, you know, if she were alive today, she would dispute you to that fact.
Really?
But she actually, yes, yes, very much so.
Now, you have several paintings on display here. Tell us about what behind, maybe behind you, maybe?
Okay, this one, I think it's very appropriate for this season, as a matter of fact, you know, with Easter coming up and so forth. This one is called La Pietà, which means the grief or the sorrow. And here depicted is the Mother Mary looking down upon the son, her son, Jesus, who is in her lap. And what it is also everything is symbolic. You know, it's not just a picture for picture's sake depicting the event. The purple, as you know, is for royalty. Gold, you know, for the kingship. The white of her veil for purity, and so on. And again, you can see the my fanaticism with detail.
Yes.
And I love anatomy and so forth. Wow. And actually, some of the imagery is made up, and some of it is actually from live models. The model depicted there, and I will state that because I'm into art, depicted there actually was not a bodybuilder. He was in construction, but had no fat content seemingly of his body whatsoever. So it was a joy to portray that because it makes me think of the perfection of Christ, you know. And so, and of course, with me depicting the what I viewed from the Bible as having hair of wool, so therefore I depicted that. And I don't know whether you can see it on camera. I also tried to go for the detail of the cut, the pierce in the side. It's got the pierce in the side, the nail prints in the hand and in the feet, and the angel peering around inside of the cave. And that's all done in pencil. That is not paint.
Oh.
So I like to push a medium to its maximum to see what it can do.
Okay, so let's back up. You said it's done in pencil.
Yes.
And then how does the color get on it? You color, I mean, help me out, educate me.
With hours and hours of dedicated passion and my hands. And inspiration from the Lord of just working an unlimited number of hours to get the detail and to the perfection that I want. And as they state, I like to try to go beyond realism. Yes.
Well, and what about maybe behind us? Here.
Now, this one is called Angelic Guidance. I must tell you, my passion is black and white, but I wanted to just say, okay, I want to show what I can do in color as well as, you know, from La Pietà. I'm planning on doing a series of angels because in this day and time that we live in, we need guidance, and more people are leaning and looking to angelic guidance and to the Lord. And so angel is kind of, you know, it can embrace anyone, whatever your thought process or belief system is. So this is showing an angel that either is stepping up or has lit down, carrying a candle to light the world with lots of detail of clouds. Thank you. Clouds in the background with the open word on a pedestal that's lifted up. And I wanted to, if you ever get close upon it, the butterflies that are flying actually have human bodies, like angelic bodies within them that are flying up. They're not just the body of a butterfly, it's a person, an angel. Yes.
You always go into the depthness of interpretation through your artwork.
And even though what I'm stating here, the interpretation is to the viewer. You know, what I say may not be what you see. That's why if people, someone walks up to me and say, well, I see this, I'm like, I will not, I don't want to input what I was trying to do.
Okay.
What do you glean from it? What do you see from it? What do you, you know, what does it say to you? And I thank God so much because I don't want my work to just to be beautiful. Mm-hmm. I love that it's appreciated and that I could get it to the level it is, or mm-hmm. blessed to get it to the level that it is. But I wanted to have a message, mm-hmm. and I wanted to speak to the viewer. Uh-huh. For one instance, I was in Laguna Beach doing a show, and a lady walked up to me, a Caucasian lady. I was openly working on artwork, and she walked up to me and she says, you know, she says, I'm not a religious person, I'm not even a spiritual person. But she said, I was working on Mount Up with Wings as Eagles is a piece. Mm-hmm. And she said, but this piece went all the way, went all through me.
Oh my.
And she says, I've got to tell you. And she says, I know you're working, but do you have time? I want to just tell you real. And she got close to me, mm-hmm. and she says, I've been told that I only have a certain amount of time to live. And she says, you know, but what you have here, it speaks to me. And she said, if there's something I need to know, she says, will you please pray for me? Hmm. And she says, at some point, I want to try to get this piece.
Wow.
You know,
oh, the door opened.
You guys are going to make me cry because the memory of it is coming back, because she was sincere. She was mm-hmm. real.
Yes.
And see, that's what I'm saying. I want the work to have a message.
Wow.
And this to be, perhaps, if one doesn't read the Bible, mm-hmm. let this be an open visual word to them of what they do not read, but they can read it within the picture. Saying 1,000 words and giving 1,000 messages
wow.
to the heart, to the spirit, to wow. the soul, mm-hmm. and beyond.
That's amazing. We are kind of down to the last couple of minutes of the show.
Yes.
What would you say to parents who are seeing some type of potential within their children? What would you say to parents, first
Please
of all?
Please encourage your children. Do what you can. If you can't afford to get them into universities for further study, do so. And take them to art shows, allow them to meet artists, you know, such as myself. You know, I don't mind giving back or trying to educate. And also I would like for the parents and adults themselves to be educated in whether you want to be a collector or you want to just buy what you like, but do support art and artists. Mm. Okay. And stand behind your children, because not only as an artist you can teach, but also if they can't teach, you don't know what avenues they may take, because
exactly.
I was into advertising art at one point, you know, very lucrative field, uh-huh. you know, where I landed actually several of the top agents in the business, mm-hmm. you mm-hmm. know, to represent me, where I did work for like McDonald's and Harcourt Brace Jovanovich Publishers mm-hmm. and United Airlines, mm-hmm. you know, and it can afford you monies that you never thought of.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And that was the first time in my life that I made enough money that I could go, I paid cash for a car mm-hmm. and had money left over. Oh, and you know, mm-hmm. that's a good feeling.
Yes, of course.
That's a good feeling. Right. So there's a lot of avenues, whether you want to pursue fine art, advertising art, teach it or whatnot, but always be 100% behind your children.
Mm.
And if I have a moment, I must say something about the Rosa Parks piece.
Okay.
Because that is, you know, the mother of modern civil rights.
Okay.
And
yes.
This piece just inspired me, because, you know, it's to be reflected on and hopefully collected. And it is done in a different tones or whatnot, but richness of tones, so that hopefully that we would not forget our history. Mm-hmm. And that's why I even have done jazz. I have a large portion of my work is jazz also, jazz, gospel, and so forth, so that our young people, again, would not forget who laid the foundation and the mm-hmm. groundwork for the hip-hop and the R&B mm-hmm. that they like to hear now. You've got to remember where you came from to know to advance, you know, in the future.
That's
and what
amazing.
To capitalize on.
We're down to the last moment. What final thought would you want to leave with us about BJ?
Know that BJ herself has a passion for people, a passion for the Lord, and a great passion for art. And if I can impart anything that inspire, again, uplifts, encourage, to touch your life, to leave a positive message, that's what I want to do, mm. and to inspire you to continue on. Mm. And to know that I love you.
Awesome. Well, we certainly appreciate you coming and sharing the
yes.
beauty and the message and the ministry of your art.
Thank you.
We have just set in royalty, even ourselves,
oh.
just being surrounded
yes.
by this. So thank
Bless
you so
you.
Much. We appreciate that.
Thank you so much. It's been my pleasure.
To you, our viewing audience, parents, be attuned to your children. You never know what they may turn out to be. You never know what skills, gifts lie with them, in them. Embrace them, encourage them to go forward,
yes.
because the lies that may be change of others mm-hmm. may come through your very mm-hmm. children.
Absolutely.
We love you. We thank God for you. Again, grab your pens and your pen. If you want to contact our prolific artist,
Buena uh-huh. Johnson,
a.k.a. BJ, then contact us and we'll be happy to put you in contact with her. Until next time, know that we love you and thank you for tuning in. God bless you.
Thank you.
Wonderful, wonderful
thank
artwork.
You. Thank you so much.
Oh, my goodness.